Previously on The Secret of Christopher Topher. What's this? Looks like a briefcase. I know this. This is ancient Egyptian Coptic language. Wow. I wish my father could see this. After the events Alex and Kieran experienced the night before, they decided to skip school and meet at the town library to share their adventures. Alex told Kieran about his adventure in the junkyard and how he managed to fall into a sewer and discover 7 scrolls. He showed her the 1 scroll he possessed and told her he was able to translate it and open a dimensional portal. He also described what he saw in the portal and how he ran for his life. Kieran explained how she and his father were arrested and questioned by the FBI at the police station.
This FBI agent asked me if I knew about a dimensional portal, and they're still detaining your father. There must be some sort of connection. We need to get the rest of those scrolls. They must be important.
Later that evening, Alex and Kieran arrived at the junkyard. Alex led Kieran into the sewer from where he had escaped the night before. He saw multiple footprints, including his own, that led out of the sewer.
The scrolls aren't here. And look, these footprints lead to the opening where I escaped. They're on to me.
Let's go to the police station and talk with your father. I'm sure he'll have some answers.
Meanwhile, the creatures were on the hunt to locate the missing scroll.
The being's trail leads this way.
Good. Let's move quickly.
At the police station, Alex, Kieran, and Mr. Smiley quietly and carefully went over the events of the previous 36 hours. The scrolls all possess unique powers. I can't remember exactly, but it looks like you have the 7th of the sacred scrolls. I discovered the scrolls while working on an excavation project for the government. I spent months trying to decode the writings. Like you, I was able to translate one of the scrolls and open a dimensional portal. I hid them in a junkyard sewer years ago. The government has been looking for these scrolls ever since. You said that the creatures will come out of the portal and enter our dimension? Then you must leave, son. They're coming after you. Don't let them capture you, and don't let them get that scroll. Moments after Alex and Kieran left the police station, they were approached by the 2 alien beings.
You, possessor of the last scroll, give me the scroll. You are coming with us.
The creatures captured Alex and Kieran and led them into the portal. Upon reaching the other side of the portal, Alex and Kieran were thrown to the ground in a heap. When Alex looked up, he saw a barren world of darkness. The chill air held a stench of death. Wind blew dirt and sand in every direction. The thundering and lightning sky was dark, with a red tint that resembled blood. There were 4 moons that gave off a faint light. The most horrifying sight was being surrounded by thousands of demonic creatures that were chanting the name of their leader.
Today is the day we get our vengeance on the enemy. Thanks to the work of our great warriors Kubanek and Ujagan, they have captured what was stolen from us. After 2,000 millennia, we now have in our possession the ancient scrolls. We also have a bonus. We have captured the maggot offspring of the Lucimox. Now with these scrolls, you shall witness the triumph of the Septon. I command that the earthly vermin that cower before us be tortured for 2 days before we feast on their flesh. 2 days to represent the 2,000 millennials we have been oppressed by our enemy.
While being held captive in a dungeon, Alex and Kieran were paid a visit by Esep.
you filth. You had our forefathers' sacred scrolls in your possession. Now you will pay. You must be hungry. Here.
Aesop reached into his pocket and threw two worm-like creatures into their cell. As soon as they hit the ground, they began to multiply. Laughing, Aesop left. In a matter of seconds, the worms had multiplied into a heap. Knowing he had to act fast, Alex retrieved a large stone from the corner of the cell, picked it up, and smashed the stone on top of the worms. Green ooze spattered into the kids and the cell floor. He did it repeatedly until all the worms were dead. Later, and without warning, a portal appeared in which a human dressed in an army uniform had emerged.
Quick, follow me!
Alex and Karen didn't hesitate. With the commotion caused by the prisoners, Kubanek and Ujigan rushed to the cell to see that the kids had escaped.